Gentlemen, welcome back to Spotlight Over the City, and we are back with a plus one, but it's not just the regular plus one. We got the big homie Big Z in the building. Give it up one time for Big Z, man. This young man got a lot going on, has done a lot, and so before I introduce him, I want to do that that big build-up like how Steve Harvey do. What he say? You seen this man on the wire. You seen this man on stage plenty of times on a set with BYB turning up. Yes. You seen him bouncing. You've made him do the thing. And now he's on Spotlight Over the City.
Yes,
tell him what's going on, Big Z.
Beautiful time, man.
Glad to be here. Glad to have you. We're so happy to have you, man. The whole city is out. They've been waiting to see you come on, and so we're glad to have you. We're gonna get into it real quick because we know that we all as black men have experienced at one point in time some situations with the law.
Yeah.
And some of them not so favorable. So what we're talking about today is not nothing personal. It's just a situation that all of us have faced. Right. So me growing up, I personally have faced a lot of adversities with the law. Just growing up in the projects, they would always assume that we were kind of doing bad or doing wrong. Right. So they would pull up us on us and do whatever. So now it's escalating because we wasn't getting killed. We wasn't getting shot by the police officers. We were getting harassed.
So it's getting crazy.
So now it's getting a little deeper. So we gotta pull it on in. And so off break, we was talking about what we need to do. So we don't want to just talk about what's happening. We want to talk about some solutions.
And we're going to get into that. We're going to pull Vanessa up. You want to tell everybody what's going on with you, Big G, before we get into all that, and then we're going to pull Vanessa on the screen.
Right. Well, I recently was incarcerated for a few weeks. I'm going through that right now. I really can't speak on it as much. But I put a situation called Hugs Not Slugs together. I feel that a lot of the young brothers growing up, how we grew up, need hugs. Mm. You know what I mean? Because a lot of them come out of them little buildings with just the mom upstairs or the grandmother, and they don't never get a hug. All they know is, hey, here go that pistol, here go a little work. You're looking at the videos, you want to get right to it. You know what I mean? Everybody want to be fresh, want to be fly, but there's consequences at the end of that rope.
That's right.
That we go through. So, you know what I mean? I came up with that. Also with the G-Socky brand. It's a sock because all homeless people, that's the less things that homeless people have is socks.
Wow.
You can give them all the food you want, but they need socks to
and
keep their feet.
I love it.
You know what I mean? So it's like they get hypothermia out there.
Yep.
So many, like especially in Washington, D.C., with the cold times, they get out there and they don't have socks. So that was another thing that we're doing. And also, we finally got the Backyard for Life brand branded. Because we were kids when it started, management wasn't popping right, and we never owned the name. So we finally owned the name.
Wow.
You know what I mean?
Love
and,
that's
that's just a big hurdle to jump over. And it's just a lot of things that we're doing right now. We're working on music. I'm on a show right now, currently on HBO. I call myself the HBO kid coming from the hood because this is my third show on HBO.
Yeah.
I'm not one of those big boys yet, but I'm here. You know what I mean?
Well,
who would ever thought that I'd be there,
we
right?
Consider you a
but
big
who would ever thought that I'd be there? You know what I mean? So it's Treme and I play Leon. Monday we debuted season 4 of the last season. And I play Leon and we're striving and pushing. That's just a lot. It's a
What's
lot
the name of
fun.
That show?
The Deuce.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's on
HBO. Yeah.
I play the cook,
your
favorite cook, your favorite chef. You know what I mean?
That's what's up, man.
So, you know.
So we like how you stretch.
It's a bunch of other stuff that I'm working on as well.
Yeah, we like how you're stretching. Like, we've seen you do a lot of different things. They don't know, well, for those who don't know, this young man also has his own tennis shoe.
Yeah, I partnered with DTLR and Patrick Ewing, and we had two successful Ewing shoes, but the Ewing brand wasn't really doing as well in the district. And they gave me that opportunity to design, and we designed the first metallic tennis shoe with the red bottom and with the DC 51 flag on it. And we sold out, and then we did the Georgetown, Welcome to G-Town, and we did well with that as well.
Love it. Big things.
I just wanted to, before we get into the topic, I just wanted to make sure people understood that you just not with Backyard Band. You just
no, that's my, that's my, that's my, that's my heart and my love. I think if it wasn't for my band, I say it all the time, I wouldn't be where I am today.
Yeah.
Because my popularity in the city really got me structured to be this person, and I was always in love with being on television, but we don't have any outlets in the city for that. So, you know, now. I mean, it stretch out, you know.
Yeah, so yes. you took advantage of the situation. And when so you mentioned the HBO kid.
Yeah.
You were kind of like a kid starting out in the acting. Yeah. How did that come about, though? Like, coming from D.C., we don't have a lot of those opportunities.
In Harriet Tubman Elementary, then we had Lincoln Junior High. It's like the male ensemble. We did putting on the wrist, dancing, singing. We did stage plays, all of that. And, like, going in, like, to Cadoza, singing in the choir, playing in the marching band, playing on French horn, mellophone. A lot of people didn't know that I did all that stuff. Wow. But it was, like, right in your in the kitchen, your big brother telling you, okay, you got that 38 over there. You got to make sure you save or do what you got to do. So it started there, and, you know, I was working on, well, with KYS. And,
I remember
that. What was it? I think Pro Scout came through. And went to Pro Scout, and everything happened from there. I think a lot of times as well, we need awareness because a lot of our young brothers and sisters don't really know the law. And a lot of people in our neighborhoods really don't teach them the law and what you are capable of knowing and capable of doing. Because if you know the law, you can let them know, look, this is not this. And I watch a lot of television. I watch CNN.
Right.
And I watch these channels. Not only are our black men under attack, our black women, the way these officers throw our women down, put handcuffs on them. Yep. I watch a Caucasian lady in a chase in California. She ran over all these stop signs, ran over people, ran like four or five people over. When they caught her in a quarter sack, they lightly put her in handcuffs. And I watched a young sister at a pool party, and I think it maybe was Kentucky somewhere, and they beat her and stepped all on her and everything.
I saw it.
And it's just sad on how they treat our black women and our black boys. And I'm not prejudiced from one bone in my body because we grew up around all nationalities. So it's the way we're being treated, and it's just like it's repeated from back when we were our ancestors. So we just have to know, we have to be aware, we have to have the awareness, and we have to know the laws, and we have to know what we are going into. And a lot of the young brothers that grow up are brought up with no father.
Yep.
Yeah.
Just that's right there. And the project is already set up for us for failure. So we have to understand that. So our politicians that we elect and put in these offices, instead of just moving around, making sure this groundbreaking museum and this is done, we need to go in the community and grab these young brothers. Just teach them. We have young black lawyers, congressmen. They can be whatever you want to be. We have to teach them and show them that they can be whatever they want. These young sisters can go to Broadway, be on Broadway, do whatever they want. But we have to teach them. Everybody go through tough times. You get rich people that have their kids that just end up on a corner or end up somewhere on drugs because they were given everything. But if you don't teach a kid and show them and help them out, they'll never know. But we have to have awareness in the community to teach them and show them the laws.
Right over the city for the youngsters.
Where y'all playing at tonight, hard. G? Y'all, you got something going on tonight?
We off tonight.
Oh, they off tonight.
Yeah, and make sure y'all support Backyard, too, man. That's Backyard Band, Big Z in the building. Deuces. Make sure y'all check it out. Guy's working. He's the hardest working man in the city, man. That's we love you, Big Z. You rock for the city. Always have stood for the city. Everybody that at the sound of my voice, if you haven't heard Backyard, make sure y'all get out there. It's not just for the youngs, but when I say be ready, because you can't have no old knees out there, you got to be ready to bounce a little bit.